Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. A schoolboy has become the youngest person to kite surf across the English Channel in just over 5 hours. Brave Adam Farrington battled 25 miles per hour winds and rough seas to complete the 69-mile journey between Poole, Dorset, and the French port of Cherbourg. The youngster completed the trip in record-breaking time, arriving 5 hours and 19 minutes after he set off. He endured a dozen wipeouts, and even had to dodge large container ships while negotiating one of the world's busiest shipping lanes. Brave Adam Farrington battled 25 miles per hour winds and rough seas to complete the 69-mile journey between Poole, Dorset, and the French port of Cherbourg. The youngster completed the trip in record-breaking time, arriving 5 hours and 19 minutes after he set off. He endured a dozen wipeouts, and even had to dodge large container ships while negotiating one of the world's busiest shipping lanes. Pictured, Adam, left with his family and the teenager, pushed through the pain barrier when his legs started cramping 10 miles from the French coast. His perseverance paid off as he eventually reached the beach, by which point he was so exhausted he could no longer walk. Bizarrely, the Guinness World Records don't have a formal record for the youngest person to kitesurf the channel, although they have officially recognized Richard Branson as the oldest person to have managed it. The Virgin entrepreneur achieved the 30-mile crossing from Dover to Calais as a 61-year-old in 2012. Adam beat the unofficial record of Brit professional kitesurfer Polly Craythorne, who achieved the feat as a 16-year-old in 2010. Adam, from Firm Down, Dorset, was inspired to do the challenge by his father, who kitesurfed around the Isle of Wight a year ago. Adam, from Firm Down, Dorset, was inspired to do the challenge by his father, who kitesurfed around the Isle of Wight a year ago. The teenager pushed through the pain barrier when his legs started cramping 10 miles from the French coast. Bizarrely, the Guinness World Records don't have a formal record for the youngest person to kitesurf the channel, although they have officially recognized Richard Branson as the oldest person to have managed it. Reflecting on his epic challenge, Adam said, "We had a couple of near misses with container ships in the shipping lanes, but the biggest challenge was the sea state. The waves were overhead for me, but also very close together and confused, making it really easy to catch an edge. I must have wiped out at least a dozen times. I found the best plan was to ride the wake coming from the back of the support boat. Having been on port tack for nearly 5 hours and with 10 miles to go, I started to get cramp in my back leg. When I finally got to the French beach, my right leg went into spasm and I couldn't kite back to the support boat. Luckily, my dad kitted to the beach and towed me back to the boat." The Poole Grammar School pupil is competing in this year's British Kitesurfing Freestyle Championships and has long-term aspirations of participating in the Olympics. He took a longer route from Poole to Cherbourg as the wind direction favoured heading there. Proud father Russell, 48, a finance consultant and keen kitesurfer, paid tribute to his son's incredible determination. "I'd like to thank my team who provided me with this amazing opportunity and gave me so much encouragement and support." The Poole Grammar School pupil is competing in this year's British Kitesurfing Freestyle Championships and has long-term aspirations of participating in the Olympics. He took a longer route from Poole to Cherbourg as the wind direction favoured heading there. Proud father Russell, 48, a finance consultant and keen kitesurfer, paid tribute to his son's incredible determination. He said, "A year ago I kitesurfed around the Isle of Wight and the plan was for me to attempt the Channel crossing, but Adam said he wanted to come along. At first the plan was for him to be on the support boat, but he has made so much progress in the past year he was desperate to try it himself. It was a nice sunny, still day when he set off, but by the mid-channel conditions were very rough with 25 miles per hour winds and holding on was a challenge. To manage that for almost 5.5 hours and completed the challenge was remarkable. I'm a very proud dad and it is amazing to see such incredible determination in your son."